When we see people who are severely depressed, they really are tormented and tortured. They often have lost all hope, often have incredibly low energy, no appetite, and very poor sleep, often take to their beds, and may have psychotic symptoms such as delusions and hallucinations. We've seen ECT be very life-transforming, that people really do get back to their regular self when no one felt there was any hope for them, including themselves. Electroconvulsive therapy is given in a series of treatments. There's generally about 8 to 12 treatments given 2 times a week. For the electroconvulsive therapy, people need to know they are given a general anesthetic to go to sleep for the treatment, so people will not remember anything. What they may remember is that an intravenous goes in and then the anesthetic and muscle relaxant is given. An electrical current is then applied to the forehead and people have a carefully monitored seizure. People wake up from the general anesthetic after about 5 minutes and often are having a meal an hour later. So again, some people may notice some confusion and some memory loss. But I must admit, everyone who's benefited from it has said the quality of their life is so poor with their depression that they don't mind having these side effects or uncomfortable feelings. They just enjoy feeling good again. The types of depression that we use this for, certainly for milder depression, we really try medications and talking therapy, but for the very severe depression, we tend to consider ECT after failures of trials of medication. There's certain subtypes of depression that particularly respond to ECT, including those people who have psychotic symptoms, such as hearing voices when there's no one around. We call that hallucinations. And also people who have what we call delusions, false fixed beliefs. ECT is a treatment choice or option. We meet with all families and patients to come up with a decision about which way to proceed with treatment. People can always elect to try a different medicine, but many of our patients have failed to get better after 4, 5, or 6 different medicines. We do our best to give them helpful information that's easy to understand to help them make this very difficult decision. It takes a lot of courage to have this treatment, and we acknowledge that. I emphasize that we've had a lot of experience with it. I think to date about 1 million people have had it, and certainly at Baycrest we've used it for well over 30 years. It is a good, safe treatment that people deserve to feel better. Our team will do our best to support them during the treatment, to make sure they feel comfortable, safe, and well cared for. And I always like to emphasize that depression is a very treatable illness.